sir.
Are you Hello, ready? My boy.
Let's haul out. Yeah. How you feeling, Jack?
I'm feeling fine, sir.
We got a decent ride ahead of us.
I've never been to Hennigan's stand. How do you know these ranchers?
I met them while I was away. The McFarlands are good people.
Indeed they are. We're gonna get some cattle. Woohoo!
Let's go.
Sure. Come on, my boy.
Was it something to do with Mr. Dutch and Bill? Why you went away?
Who told you that?
I kept hearing people say their names. That's all.
Yeah, I caught up with Bill and Dutch. We had some old business needed settling.
Where are they now?
They're gone, son. We won't be seeing them again.
They were angry at you, weren't they? That's why we had to leave.
They was just good men who turned back. I'll explain it to you one day.
And what does that make you?
I guess careful. I'm a bad man who tried to be a good father. I don't know. Every man has a right to change. A chance of forgiveness. Ain't that what the good book says?
You've never read me the good book, sir.
Well, I imagine that's what it says. Yeah!
I don't know. I'm just riding. My horse is fast. Marshmallow 2.
Talk later, son. Right now, I need to concentrate on not getting us lost.
Okay.
There's the ranch. Come on. Let's see if we can find Mr. McFarland.
Mr. McFarland. How's it going, sir?
John Marston. There's a face I thought I'd never see again. Our public servants in Blackwater sent you back on another homicidal errand to protect and save us from Lord only knows what.
Thankfully not, sir. I was hoping you might still be able to sell me some cattle.
My boy, it would be a pleasure. Bonnie's out to crow now. She'll be more than happy to help you.
All right.
Take care now, Mr. McFarland. Good luck.
Ride to Bonnie. To Bonnie.
All right, Jack. You're gonna have an important job.
Good Lord, do my eyes deceive me? A devil walks among us.
I said I'd be back when this was all over, Miss McFarland. After the barn fire, you remember?
Of course I remember. I just didn't believe a word of it. So, you've come for some cattle?
Yeah, I'm finally starting up my farm again. Or trying to, at least.
You'll be fine. You've been taught well. Come on, then.
Let's do it.
Come.
Moving position. Also, welcome back, Olek. Welcome back. How was your night? I'm gonna drive some cattle, baby.
Go! Head for the river, son! Road! Come on, let's go! Let's go! Easy.
I'll give you a hand to get them moving.
Good luck, John! Come back and see you sometime!
So, what happened? Last I heard, you were headed for some exotic escapade in Mexico.
It's a long story. Too long to tell without a drink in my hand.
Back to the riddles, I see. And Mr. Williamson?
Move it up.
So, is this your boy?
Yeah. Say hello to Miss McFarland, Jack. Yeah.
Come on, Kals.
How's your wife?
She's well, I think. We haven't had much time to talk yet.
Well, I'm glad you're back together again.
It's gonna take some time. We've all been through a lot. Stay together, you dumb animals. Come on. How's the ranch?
We're surviving. Looks like you got him under control. I'd best get back to Paul.
Nice to see you again, Miss McFarlane. And thanks for everything.
Bonnie, you don't.
Later, Bonnie.
Jack, we need to move him across the river.
Nice.
Yeah. You're doing a good job, son. Just lead them straight up the hill towards home.
Will do, Paul.
Come on.
Come on, Kals.
Let's go.
Giddy up. God, look at that scenery. It's beautiful.
Whoa.
It's a long drive of cows, man. No stragglers now.
Hold up, Jack. This don't look right. I'll deal with this. Stay with the herd, Jack.
I think we'll get the cattle. Okay. Come here, cow.
I think that's all up. Jack, wait there, I'm coming. Yeah.
Come on, cow. Do it.
Let's go. Come on.
There's all these random horses around.
You all right? You're not hurt, are you?
No, I'm fine. I'm fine. I wasn't scared, honest.
Sorry you had to see that, son. Those men won't be stealing from anybody else. All right, let's round up the stragglers and get moving.
Let's do it. Giddy up!
Jack, head left up the road towards home.
I know where I'm going, Paul.
I know where I'm going, Paul. Paul. Two cows getting separated.
Whoa there.
Go, go.
What? Slow.
Go.
Move. Come on. Go. Whoa! Keep it moving! Let's go!
Uh-oh.
Come on!
Got him.
Forward!
All right. Now lead him into the pen. Yeah. Easy.
Got ourselves some cows.
We made it.
Did real good out there. Go on. Hit your horse and wait for me by the stable. Come on. Hey.
Father and son bonding moment.
That's a fine herd we got ourselves.
And I didn't miss any cows, Potion.
Did a good job, son. Nice shooting.
Thanks, Pa.
Make a rancher of you yet.
Fantastic. Alright, let's get in the house and go to sleep. Get some ammo. All right, Potion. Good night, bud. Good luck with your lecture tomorrow. And I'll see you tomorrow. Have a good night. Have a great night, bud. How's it going, girl? Ah, it's good to be home.
What you cooking?
Same thing I've been cooking the past 15 years with the hope of poisoning you.
Ain't working so well.
Not yet.
Be honest, though. Tastes bad enough to kill a man.
I never was much of a cook, but I did try to be a good wife.
And you have been.
Given what we was and what we came from, I think we've gone and done okay. I look at Jack. I look at him, and I think we've been blessed. Maybe he can be something more.
He's a good kid. He can be whatever he wants to be. He ain't gonna be no frontier gunslinger killing and running no gang, though. That way's over. Railroads and government, motor cars and everything gone and done away with all that.
And he ain't gonna marry no orphaned working girl running with a bunch of hucksters, neither.
If he meets one like you, I hope he'll marry her.
Stop. For an illiterate gunslinger, you sure know how to make a girl blush. God damn crows! John! You have got to go deal with them. They've broken into the silo again and are eating all the corn out from it.
Of course, my angel.
Wait, get out of there!
All right.
Come on! Scat! Shh.
All right. That's a lot of crows, man. Need some dynamite. Do I have to climb up here? No, I can't.
Damn it!
I guess I gotta just keep killing the... Did I lose or win? No, we won. We won. Woo! Coke Crow.
Finally. How about that stew?
Nice. Ba-da-ba-ba. Let's go ahead and save again. Got more missions to do. Late night stream here indeed. We're almost at the end of the game. We're really, really close to the end. So we are playing it to the end. So buckle up. Okay, it's time sensitive. Okay, we gotta sleep again. We have like 5 or 6 more missions. Seven. We have 7 more. So, a few more. Sounds good, OPG. It's gonna be good to have you. What time is it? I gotta rest one more dang time. Well, they've got a Halloween update they just dropped with zombies and stuff. Ba-da-ba-ba.
How are
you? Old friends, new problems.
John, we got a telegram from some lady friend of yours, a Bonnie something or other. Something you ain't telling me?
Bonnie McFarlane. She's a friend. Mm. Saved my life when I went after Bill and nearly got myself killed again.
Oh, and now you two's in the habit of sending each other letters. How very nice.
Weren't nothing like that. What's it say?
I don't know. I can't. Well, you know I can't read.
Give it here.
You read that thing out loud.
I ain't hiding nothing. Dear Mr. Marston, stop. Need corn sacks. Stop. Emergency. Stop. Weevils and moths ate entire county supply. Stop. Can you help? Not exactly the most romantic request now, is it?
I guess not. She saved your life, you say?
Yes, ma'am.
Well, then you're gonna have to help her and her family out. We've got a plentiful supply of corn sacks over near the silo. About the one thing Uncle didn't manage to have stolen while he was gone.
Okay.
Hurry back, John. And John, what's she like?
You know. A little bit like you, I guess. She's a woman in a man's world.
All right, let's get in the wagon.
Changed my mind. I'm coming with you. Well, come on, man. Let's get going.
Let's do it.
I don't think I can let you go off again without
I'm glad of the company. You only had to ask.
Ask? I was waiting for you to ask me.
I thought you'd want to keep an eye on the boy.
Oh, while you were off cavorting with cowgirls in the next county? I don't think so, John Marston. You only just got home. That Jack has seen enough of me for a lifetime. So, is she married? Is Bonnie McFarland?
No.
What does she look like?
I don't know. Pretty normal, I suppose.
Normal? What? Normal like me?
No. Normal as in two eyes, mouth, nose, that kind of normal. Besides, ain't no woman fine as you.
A little flattery. Now we're finally getting somewhere.
If you find yourself in a hole, the first thing to do is stop digging.
Another pearl of wisdom from John Marston. I sure do miss those.
I never took you for the jealous type, Abigail.
I ain't jealous so much as curious.
You heard what she wrote. It's just some corn. She saved my life, and she was decent enough to me, so I owe her this much at least.
Smart man indeed.
Anyway?
She found me half dead on the side of the road and took me to the doctor. Those folks would have left me there.
Half dead from what?
Bill didn't take so kindly to me fishing unannounced.
Bill never did like surprises. How was he?
Same as he was when we left. Angry and dumb. Taking his revenge out on the world. People down there was really scared of him.
Of Bill? You gotta be kidding me. He was only frightening if he was afraid of dumb fools.
Bill weren't so bad, but when Dutch went crazy, Bill took it hard.
For a while, we all thought we found something right. Better way to live, but it was just a lie. So you saw before they did.
Maybe. But they was still kind of a family.
A family that left you for dead. You knew the truth, John. And they hated you for it.
God, I love the dialogue.
Those government bastards. Where did they hold you and Jack?
I ain't sure. They kept their eyes covered there and back. Can't have been too far from here, though.
They treat you right?
It ain't the first time I've had a gun to my head, John. You're forgetting your marriage proposal.
Gun to her head, marriage proposal.
You came. Thank you so much. We lost the entire harvest.
Miss McFarland, I'd like you to meet my wife, Abigail.
Oh, ain't you quite the gentleman all of a sudden? It's a pleasure to meet you, Mrs. Marston. Likewise, thank you for saving my husband's life and for teaching the miserable goat some manners, among other things. I didn't teach him anything. I know better than to try to change a man. You should meet my father. Oh, people can change, Miss McFarland. John and I have to believe that more than anybody.
This is a decent first harvest for you, John. You should be proud. That's good land you got there.
How are you feeling, Mrs. Marston? From what your husband told me, it must have been awful for you. I've been through worse, and I knew he'd be back before too long. He can't cook a meal to save his life.
Abigail, in my darkest hours, when I was most homesick, just the thought of one of your rat meat stews kept me pushing forward.
Well, about as amusing as a weeping saddle sore, ain't he, Mr. Farland? You're gonna start yammering about women's work, John. I'd say you might be in the wrong company. I'd say so, too.
I never felt so outnumbered.
Good times. Good times. Oh,
ma'am.
She's kind of sad. She likes him.
I'm only teasing. I like her. And I'm glad she saved your life.
McFarlands are good people.
She did blush redder than a shepherd's sunset when she saw you, though.
I have that effect on women.
You've clearly had one too many blows to the head.
You ain't wrong about that, Mrs. Marston.
That's quite a ranch they got there.
That'll be us someday. As soon as we get back on our feet.
I don't know, John. How many times can we start again? An outlaw and a working girl. We ain't exactly farmers.
We are now. Forget that life. It's over.
Do you really believe that?
We have to. It's the only way we'll ever have a future.
The life we led, that doesn't go away. It's never over. You think those government men are just gonna leave us alone now?
The old gang's dead. I did what they asked.
And that's it? A life of crime forgiven?
We're back together, ain't we?
Till they decide you owe them something else.
Sometimes I think I was the stupid one for believing I could get out. Maybe Dutch, Bill, and Javier were just being honest with themselves.
You ain't perfect, John, and I sure ain't. But you're better than they are, than they were.
Maybe we can't change. But we gotta try, for Jack's sake. Even if we have to start again 100 times. Better than going back to what we were. How's Jack doing?
Angry, upset. He's been through a lot.
I hope he's gonna be all right.
It's gonna take time. For a while, his world was safe. Normal, even. Then it got turned upside down again.
He ain't saying much about it.
I've tried to talk to him. But how do you explain any of it? What do you say when he asks about Uncle Bill and Uncle Dutch? They were family when he was a little boy.
He hides away in those books of his.
Wouldn't you? It ain't like the real world's done him many favors. He's just been kidnapped. He grew up with the gang. That's no life for a boy.
It's true.
We did good today, John. I guess I better go fix us something to eat.
Absolutely. Supper. Only the cutest. Family member not there. Come back later. Oh, there you are. Let him get to position. Jack's walking to his area too. Boy. I know they're not here right now. Dang it. Vivian, there's not here right now. Come back later. He's right there! Okay. Game lies to me. This game. Let's just do like a little mile around the house, shall we? Doggo! We got this mission. We'll do this one. By sweat and toil.
Get up, old man.
I am up.
Get up!
There, I'm up. Thank the good Lord you're back. Nothing worse for an old man than sleeping in the warm afternoon sun.
Going a long sleep, Uncle?
That can be arranged. It'll cost me less than food.
You always was a hard, nasty man, John Marston.
You always was a useless, conniving thief. And where's them cattle? Did you take them to pasture?
It's coming around to that.
When exactly?
It's easy to pick on the elderly. It's easy, but it ain't dignified.
Come on, old man. Do this together.
Should be lucky that he has a free meal and can drink and sleep.
Go.
All right, you stay front. Come on, let's get him out to pasture.
Marshmallow 2.0.
Whoa there.
Hustle on up.
We don't talk about anything else.
Come on.
We've always had Marshmallow 2.0.
Come on, you dumb heifers.
Let's go. Whoa.
Them pit.
Come on, easy up now. Easy.
Come on. Not into the train. Take out the outlaws.
Damn, almost felt that one.
The guy, look at those guys flying.
Let's go.
Oh, speak to the engineer. Whoa. Go wrangle up the cows.
The hero returned. They don't know how lucky they are.
Shut it, old man. Come on. Let's get this herd moving again. Whoa. Let's move them out.
No, 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 no. Get back. Back into the herd. No stragglers.
Move! Come on!
Keep it moving!
This pasture is a long way away. Got him.
You look after the herd. I'll ride back.
No thanks. You got your pound of flesh from me today.
All right. So I guess that's it. We head back home. How far away are we? God, we're far.
Go.
I guess we're just gonna leave our cows there. I'm okay with that. We actually made really good time, all things considered, for beating this game. We had really, really good time. Actually, since we're here, let's do another one of these missions.
What are you looking at, old man?
There's some Mustangs and some such out there beyond that ridge. Wondering if it was worth getting you and going around some of them up.
Fair enough. We're nearly out of money. Ranch is in turmoil. We may not make it through the winter. What could we possibly want with some good quality horses? Come on.
That tone of voice ain't so becoming on you. Makes you seem all pent up and angry like some Blackwater would-be business tycoon with a bad case of hemorrhoids.
I'll give you a bad case if someone just shot me in the head if you don't hurry up.
There's a cougar in the background! Did anyone else see that cougar? What's going on there? Also, yes, Wesley Chosen, we're right there. We got like two or three more missions. Go get some horses.
Yeah.
Am I paranoid? Are you sure I'm paranoid? Are you sure, Wazzy Chelsea? Because I see to my left a cougar.
Why you gotta act so diggity all the damn time? What happened to
you? What were you gonna do? Just look at them horses all day?
Well, God forbid I'd do anything around here without checking with His Royal Highness first.
Yeah, you're real good at watching. That's about all you're good for, apart from bending your elbow.
I can't do right for doing wrong. You're an ungrateful bastard, you know. I did my best when you was gone.
Your best is like anybody else's worst.
Getting old. I gotta start taking things easy.
You've been taking things easy for 40 years.
Yeah. There you go. Look, there they are. Don't let go. Whoa, there. Come on there, quick.
Careful.
Woo! Got him.
Friends,
don't fall off.
Shut the hell up.
Mount back up, you fool.
It must hurt the pickle. I agree. Why is it chosen? I've never been horseback riding, but I imagine it's like a bad case of colitis.
Come
Why don't you come over here and try to break one?
You're mine now.
There you go. You got him now, John.
Whoa. Relax now. I got you now.
Where are you really going with that horse?
Let's do it.
Well, see it. Yeah, yeah. Another one. He's right there.
Quiet, old man.
Now.
Come on.
Let's do it.
Come on.
I want that white one. Ooh, that one looks cool. Come on, break! Be my friend! Speak horse and enter! Got him. How many horses we're getting? Alright, let's do it. Good day. We've got some horses to help the farm. It's gonna be good.
Let's go.
Okay. Also, let's make sure the cougar is not around. Could be an issue.
Come on. Make sure there's enough fresh hay. We need to keep them strong.
All right. Damn, a little gratitude wouldn't kill you. Not a bad day's work.
Indeed.
All
right. All right. Let's see if there's still... Yes, there is. Bingo. John Marston and Son.
What's the book, boy?
Nothing, sir.
What's it about?
Well, it's an adventure, sir. Set out in the West, and it tells this amazing story of how people killed the savage Redskins, and how this man... this brave man hunts the man who killed his father.
I'm glad you're enjoying it. Talking of adventure, how'd you like to learn to track elk? Really big ones in the valley this time of year. We could use the meat.
Well,
I know you'd rather read your adventures. Trust me, this can be very enjoyable in its own way. I suppose maybe it's a little less dramatic. So, let's go, come on. You may get to see me get gored by some massive wild beast. Then you can write a story about that.
Very funny, Paul. I've forgotten how funny you was.
Grab your things.
All right. Let's go hunt some elk. Come on, boy! Boy!
Alright, now stay close to the dog, son. Slow.
Rufus is the dog's name!
Easy.
I forgot about that.
If you find something, you stay back and I'll show you how to make a kill.
Whatever you say, sir.
Easy. You sure you're ready for this?
I guess so.
Now the trick to hunting is calm and patience. You gotta think and move like an animal to catch an animal.
A rifle helps, doesn't it?
Elk don't stand still, son.
I wouldn't know. This is the first time you've taken me hunting.
There's lots of things I ain't done with you, but I'm gonna try and make up for that. You don't seem too excited about this.
What do you want me to say, Paul? Yippee?
Are you sure you're all right? I mean, I know all that business must have been hard on you.
It wasn't nothing. I'm not a kid anymore.
Well, it won't happen again. It's over.
Until the next time you meet?
Jack, he's on to something. There won't be a next time.
Don't make no more promises, Paul. I've heard them all before.
Come on, easy up now. You know, one time I hunted a bear up in tall trees. You never seen a bigger animal in all your life.
I read this story about a girl who was raised by wolves. She'd hunt goats with them and everything.
Sounds like a tall yarn to me.
Taller than a boy being taken from his home and locked up in a dungeon?
I'm just saying. Maybe you spend too much time with your head in those books. Look, I see one.
Yeah, I see it.
This one's mine. Stay with me, son.
Let's go.
Go.
I do not see it.
Easy. Shouldn't we be saving those bullets?
Ride 'em, cowboy.